Good evening. Welcome to Wheel of Sports TV. Dick Herman here. Chris Perry joining me in the booth today. Gino Gang on the field. We ought to keep him down here the whole game,
Chris. And Chris Murray right down front here.
Chris Murray is cooling down a bit, but...
I believe, actually, you know, they have, with these games, tournament-type games, they need to have an official, like, site supervisor. And so, actually, Chris Murray is playing a valuable role. I believe today he is the site supervisor.
Site supervisor,
yes.
Right.
So it's good to have him here. He's usually here for all the home games. And thank you, Dick. I have big shoes to fill today. Jeremiah off-island. So I am pinch-hitting. So a shout-out to Jeremiah.
Are you sure he's off-island? I thought it was a switch today. I thought you were coming up here and Jeremiah was going to go down and officiate the game.
Well,
that didn't work out.
If you ask Jeremiah, he does a better job than I do officiating the game. And we also have our weekly I&M representative.
Our crack statistician down there.
Yes.
Anytime we need any info, Dean fires it up to us. He's a good man.
Well, let's talk a little bit about Old Rochester before we get fired up here. Coming over here this morning, dressed in their white tops, black bottoms, Nantucket in their whites, top and bottom. Old Rochester coming in with a 14-6 record. I believe they were the 11th seed, and our crack statistician can verify that.
You're right. I know that for a fact.
They beat Bristol Plymouth in the first round 9-2, and they come here, despite the fact they have a couple of big guys size-wise, a very young team, no seniors. And one thing that might be helping the Whalers this afternoon is the fact that Old Rochester graduation was yesterday, so we're hoping for a little graduation hangover, or graduation, whatever you want to call it, from yesterday's festivities over in the Rochester, Marion, Wareham area.
I sort of guessed that because Old Rochester actually played a day before Wednesday, and then we won on Thursday, and there's normally a two-day... spread in there. When a game could put to Sunday, that's what I figured was going on at graduation.
Well, the human vacuum, number four, Sylvia, with the face-off, nothing new to report. You know, he reminds me, I don't know, if you go back several years, there was a guy that was nicknamed the human vacuum who played for the Whalers named Sean Dew. And you see him downtown every once in a while in pop-up stores that he's famous for getting going. And he was a ground ball face-off animal like Sylvia. And certainly he's following in those footsteps. So Whalers starting out on defense, which is hard to believe, with Sylvia generally facing off. 30 seconds into it, rain holding off, Dick, and we can sneak in a couple of sponsors here.
Sun coming out right now. The rain's supposed to come in heavy tonight. The portions of this game brought to us by Don Allen Auto Center. New and used vehicles on sale at Don Allen Auto Center.
Old Rochester with a freshman in goal. Good size guy, number 38. His name is... Kane.
They are a good sized club. I was surprised you said there's no seniors on here. They're going to be a much bigger club next year when all these guys grow.
They've been in the tournament the last couple of years and have done fairly well. Whalers playing a bit of a zone here. And I think the high school level, this level, is often frustrated with zone defenses. Typically, they're used to man to man. So zone defenses can throw off an offense. And we've seen that when they effectively put a zone on the Martha's Vineyard against Hull and some other teams. Nantucket with the turnover, zipping upfield for the Whalers. Day right down the middle, possible fast break, 4-on-3. Over to the left, spin, taking it out nicely. 29 for the Whalers, starting Campbell.
Whoa.
Nice save, good shot and a nice save. So we'll give him the first save of the day and the first save of the afternoon.
Ethan got that. He took it from the left side, not his strongest side, I think, but he really put a nice shot on net.
Little love tap, Sylvia with the ground ball, coming onto the field. Day, number 6 for the Whalers. Nantucket getting the ball into the box. Once you cross midfield, you have to get it into the box within 10 seconds.
The winner of this game goes up against Hull. Nantucket split with Hull this year. You said you saw Old Rochester earlier this year?
I saw them earlier in the year.
And you saw Hull. How does Hull and Old Rochester compare?
Hull is substantially better. Obviously, when the seeds were put together, that was the matchup they were hoping for, get the Hull-Nantucket rubber game of the match. At the same time, put Norwell up top with Cohasset.
Another save for the goalie, and Nantucket got it right in front. Not much of a shot, but goalie had to kick it out. Nantucket controlling it here a little. Let's see if they can get a
No reason for a recount by the official DiPaolo on the other side, since Old Rochester did not gain possession of the ball, but Whalers came up with it in the box. Gambroni behind, back out top, Lombardi looking for somebody. Fairly patient so far. 8.5 minutes to go. One big save by freshman goaltender Kane for Rochester. Coach Marsh Chambers yelling out some instructions on offense. Little pick, nothing doing.
Campbell and Gamboni were the ones that got the offense going the other day.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, Sunday tilts, you know, type like this, you just need, you know, 5 or 8 minutes just to get your feet under you, get loosened up, get the juices flowing. You know, their bodies are typically kind of winding down on a Sunday. And here we are playing a second round of the tournament. So I wouldn't be surprised if both teams just need 5 or 8 minutes to just sort of get the competitive juices flying.
Yeah, you talk about Rochester going.
Bang.
Oh, yeah.
There it is. There we go. And that's Mr. Fye with the first goal of the afternoon. Came out from his right to left. Fye, one of the few left-handed players on the Whalers. The Whalers jump out one zip, 8 minutes to go in the game. Dick, and that goal brought to us by?
That goal brought to us by the IANO Steamship Authority. Book online at steamshipauthority.com. The IANO, the way to go. $50 round trip starting on the island. And Ethan Fye with the goal. Any assist on that one?
I think we'll give it unassisted. What's demoralizing for any team that plays the Whalers is when they score, with Sylvia taking the faceoff, you know, they score in bunches. So it's, you know, they come down, they score, then they get possession of the ball again, and they come down and they, you know, obviously have an opportunity to score again. So the Whalers' offense is bunches. They score 2, 3, 4 at a time.
Now, I've spoken about this before. Sylvia walked right in there. He's looking to make a nice pass to JT in the crease, but I think he can take 2 or 3 more steps and just blast it at the goalie.
Yeah. And I think he will learn that more and more as soon as he gets up into the collegiate level. Being an unselfish player, certainly trying to keep everybody involved, but you're right. But at the same time, he's not going to get so many of those chances in college.
No.
When he gets clean breaks, since he's going to get, will go up against tougher and tougher competition.
Did you see any of that championship game, North Carolina and Maryland?
Yeah.
What a game.
Number two's their one of their big weapons on offense for Rochester. Also number four, Terrell. I apologize if I made a mistake on that name. Their other captain is number 15, a defenseman, Rigo.
There's the first big save there.
Yep. Right off the chest, notice, not a bounce shot, really wasn't labeled, just sort of stuck it right in there. First save.
Ooh, big hit there.
Sylvia with the ball.
Sylvia stays alive, though. Now, here's the rocks. Let's see if he takes this shot. Yes!
Oh, Pice.
Oh! Did that hit both posts?
No, hit post and then the goalie on the way out. Shot wide, backed up nicely. Notice Gambroni in perfect position behind the net. 16 coming on the field, Lombardi. Sylvia coming off, getting a little
Sylvia
breather.
Ping-pong that one, the post, and you said the goalie.
Yeah, it looked like
Then came back out. It looked like a double post to me, right? This JT, he gets denied.
He gets slashed, then denied.
Campbell. I was waiting for Campbell to get involved. Well, he took it upon himself to get involved. He just took that charge all the way around. And
nicely done. Just kept coming and coming. He really went through like 2 or 3 different zones of defensive layers and popped that one in. That goal brought to us by?
Albert G. Brock wants to wish each and every student the very best summer coming up. Brock Insurance here to provide you with all your insurance needs. You're heading off to college, check with Albert G. Brock for some insurance you may need. All right, Sylvia dominating out there. And this one is knocked away, but Nantucket
That was a clear win by Nantucket. He intentionally pulled it back like that, Dick.
So that is a play.
Oh, no, that's a set play.
Set play.
Yeah,
he does. Well.
He's very effective 2 different ways, clamping and brushing it forward, or clamping and pulling it back to his left. And he'll tell the wing midi what he's going to do. And if you'll notice, that wing midi will either go up to the midfield line if it's going to be a forward motion, or he'll drop back into sort of that semi-defensive position if he's going to clamp and draw it back.
Well, that play worked perfectly there.
Yeah, they're terrific at that. Good shot, bang. Thank you. and good night. Now, if I was the coach, that's Coach Justin Shea for Rochester, it might be time for a timeout. And it is, in fact, a timeout.
Was that Sylvia with that one?
Sylvia with the Rocket, 3-0 Whalers, 5:33 left to go in the first quarter, and the Whalers are rolling.
I'd like to mention some of our fine sponsors bringing this game. The UPS Store, Don Allen Auto Center, Santa's Rubbish Removal, Outdoor Power, Stova Engineering, Pete's Fresh Fish Prints, Valero & Sons, Fast Forward, Fairgrounds Restaurant, The Sea Grill, The Island of Packers Store, Barco Sea Tacos, Harbor Fuel Oil Corporation, The Beauty Bar, William Welch Gallery, Island Variety, Island Pharmacy, Condon & Coleman Insurance, Island Fencing, Nantucket Boys and Girls Club, The Hawthorne House, Rideau Electric, Kitty Muratogs, Just Do It 2, The Dog Wash, Great Lady Insurance, Champion Rentals, TNT Lawn Sprinkling, Albert G. Brock Insurance, Island Lumber, Martin Bork Painting, Sherbin Management, and the Downing Fleet. We thank some of these fine sponsors bringing this, and you too would like to be a sponsor. You can pick it up now, all for $7.50, and this will run through the Island Cup games, the Discovery ad, a 2 to 3 minute piece where Gino discovers what your business is about, the 15 second ad, that's separately sold for $500 per month right there, and the graphic ad, and that's for 6 months. Your logo on the screen playing 24/7, all this for just $7.50 now through the Island Cup game. And give Gino a call if you have any interest, 508-292-2203. So all Rochester, a quick timeout, you call the Chris. What does he tell his kids when they come off the field?
Well, I think it's a different message to this group than the message he would have given his team last year, and that is last year's team's seniors and juniors, you know, don't panic, a lot of time left, let's turn the ball over and get our seniors involved. This year, young team, probably a lot of new faces, hard to really get those guys confident. As I said, the Whalers typically score in bunches. I've seen it firsthand on the field. So you see how the defensive midi is back there? That's a perfect play by Sylvia. Unfortunately, not a good ground ball by Lombardi, but they did get it. So I think it's going to be a tough road for old Rochester to handle because they just don't have the senior leadership that can sort of right the ship and get them back in the game.
Sylvia had the ball knocked away, but right to Campbell, who got off a quick shot, didn't get it on net, but Nantucket regains possession.
It's the only sport out there where you can take the shot, miss the net, and then regain possession of the ball. You know, basketball, you miss and goes out, goes the other way. But in this case, you know, offense is at a premium, so you want to reward the offensive team for an act of shooting.
Push on Nantucket, no control. So the turnover gives all Rochester a chance. They need a goal here in a hurry to stem the tide. Nantucket, three straight goals.
Yep.
Oh, and there's a throwaway there. That's a rookie mistake right there.
Yeah, it was a poor job by Nantucket riding on their offensive half of the field, and then the Rochester player really just turned it over for no reason. But we'll take it. This is an automatic clear when you give it to Small in his speed, so you're just not going to stop him in the open field. Swim move and award, but it wasn't called. Score.
Oh.
I can't believe that wasn't called. In fact, the coach for Rochester is screaming at the official, and rightly so. I mean, he clearly pushed the stick away. But we'll take it. Right. Certainly not going to be turned away in Nantucket Gold Duck brought to us by.
That call brought to us by Nantucket Island Pharmacies. We've got you covered in town and out of town. In town, 45 Main Street. Out of town, 122 Pleasant Street. Both pharmacies offer you prescriptions, nutrition, beauty products, health aid. Qualified, knowledgeable staffs, Nantucket Island Pharmacies.
Yeah, both coaches are all over this guy because it was a blatant ward. But we'll take the goal. Sylvia with it. Remember when I said how the Whalers score in bunches? And this is a perfect example. They score, they get possession, bang, they're right on offense.
Yeah, that 9 times out of 10, Cole buries that one. That one, they just came up a little short, but they do have possession.
And it's demoralizing for another team, and unless you can develop that face-off specialist or better at ground balls, Nantucket is continually going to get the ball on offense. Now, if they go against Hull, another goal, number two game, that's his first of the afternoon, actually. 5-0, I believe, Whalers, and this game is over.
getting out of control early. We only have played
little over 8 minutes, 8 minutes and 7 seconds to be exact. And Nantucket, as you said, probably has this game put away because old Rochester team, they're not going to have the ability, the leadership to come back.
They don't have the skill. As I said, just give the Whalers, they needed about 5 or 8 minutes just to get their juices going as opposed to sitting at home watching a baseball game or relaxing or doing their homework. And they got their legs under them now, and obviously old Rochester's still on the ferry. Sylvia with the ball. Oh, great look. See you later. This is textbook now. That is a textbook dish to Campbell in a terrific shot. That's six. And I don't know if we're going to run out of sponsors by halftime, Dick. Let's have another.
That big goal brought us by Nantucket Island. Nantucket Airlines, and I was on them this morning, I sure remember that. Nantucket Airlines, call now for reservations, 228-6234. A little fog this morning, about an hour late getting out of Hyannis, but they got me here, unless I'd be rushing up here on that boat, Gino. I'd be showing up now.
Now, ooh, if I was a betting man, he's going to draw that one back. Sort of a good scrum, because you see the defensive players for Nantucket were in position.
One thing I'm going to keep an eye on is that since Old Rochester is a young team, and since they're very big, this could get a little bit physical. They may go to that route just by accident, you know.
Yeah.
Feeling they're getting embarrassed, they may just start whacking around people. And now you got to start thinking. You got to probably play hard one or pick up any injuries.
The Whalers are in a zone, which is good. They're content. They don't care if this game ends 5-0.
Right.
They're content sitting back, letting them shoot from the outside, protects the goal a little bit. And it's hard to come back if you're playing against the zone. And the only way you beat a zone, you have to overload it. Like you go to 1-4-1 or something where you get two offensive players against one defensive player. And that's what you can do against the zone.
Well, Nantucket certainly shown they have much more speed than Old Rochester. I can see that early here. They've had two or three guys just completely run away from the red
52
shirts.
52 just hit Small right in the head. Good call by Sammy there. Got a timeout with about 2.5 to go. Dick, let's sneak a couple of sponsors in as we're looking at a 6-0 lead for the Whalers.
I'd like to mention Restaurant Fine Sponsors bringing you this special boys tournament game, Island Variety, Island Carpets, Connor Electric, James Light and Roofing, Expresso to Go, Randy Alford Plumbing and Heating, Scrimshaw Gallery, Eastwood Trading Company, Glidden's Island Seafood, Geronimo's Cottage and Castle, Joe Rapacki, Killen Real Estate, Cam Appliance, Rick's Paint and Maintenance, Nantucket Seafood, Nantucket Boost Club, Nantucket Health Club, Fazzaro's Homemade Italian, Varian Masonry, Axe Screen and Window Repair, Nantucket Airlines, Steamship Authority, Joe Manning and Associates, Sun Island Fuel, Nantucket Trees, Nantucket Electric Contractors, Right Construction, and the Downey Flake. We thank all these fine sponsors for bringing you portions of the this big tournament game.
With the timeout going on here, I think it's really important to message something that I've noticed on the field over the last couple of years, and really this year, and that is the incredible calming influence of the Whaler coaching staff. And this is something over the last couple of years, Sam and company has done a terrific. I mean, if you look at him right now, you know, he's not screaming at his kids. I know they're up 5 or 6-0. He's not lecturing them. He's got them total attention, under control, coaching when it's necessary. Done a terrific job, and this year and last year especially, a really noticeable on the field, sort of quarter to quarter, game to game adjustments.
Yeah, as you say, there's all types of coaches. Some of us like different styles more than others. I'm with you. I like Stan's style. Keep the kids' attention. If you keep their attention, you don't have to yell at them because they're listening to every word you say.
Yep. He's done a nice job, and I think he'd be the first to admit that, you know, he's learned along the way too. Not only the people that he's coaching, but also the rules of the game, in-game adjustments. I'll give you a good example when we have a break. One that really stood out to me during the Vineyard game.
But he didn't have lacrosse when he was in high school, so
no.
he didn't have the chance to play it. You know?
See, this kid number 28, see, physically, there's just no way he's going to keep up against the defensive players of, you know, Lester, Starr, Lombardi, and others. There's just no way.
Yeah, 28 looks like a young
Willard,
freshman.
Davidson,
sometimes you have
Hickman.
Good-sized freshman. He looks like a young, small freshman,
yeah,
28.
Yeah, you know, going against a Small, Day, Sylvia. Hickman. There's just no way he can physically hand up. Now, the Whalers are content. They can hang back there all day long if they want. You can just see this is an inexperienced team that doesn't know how to react to a zone.
Well, Rochester needs a goal here to break the shutout here in the first period.
Marsh just told him to get back into the zone. There's just no way. You cannot come back against a zone unless you play a 1-4-1 type of offense. This is not going to work. Plus, he's standing in the crease. He's literally standing in the back of the crease.
That was blocked. That'll be Rochester.
Ref didn't see it. 2 feet standing right on the crease. There he is again. His left foot is in the crease. He's in the crease.
They're letting it go. Huh?
The ref is looking right. He's literally in the back of the crease. I mean, I can see it from here. They have to go to a 1-4-1 and overload the zone, or they're not going to get these scoring opportunities. Yep. Marsh and Sam both yelling sticks
up. There's too many redshirts just standing around.
They just don't have the skills to come back, and the Whalers are just too good.
That's a big goal.
Yep, let them have it. Let me tell you, that'll be the last time number two gets that opportunity. Number two with the goal, Gogan. I believe that's his 52nd of the year.
Yeah, that was a nice move by him. I didn't think he had any anger whatsoever, and he buried it.
He's got 51 or 52 goals on the year, so certainly an experienced goal scorer. That first goal by Old Rochester scored
it's just not the spice of life. Gifts, party favors, graduation cards. We congratulate all the seniors. They'll be graduating 5 days from now, next Saturday, and get over to Island Variety and get your graduation cards for your seniors.
Plus, my niece is going to work there this summer. She's traveling from Hawaii, living with me, and she's going to be working over at Island Variety.
Does she speak?
Oh, yeah?
Does she speak English?
She does. She is. She goes. Each year, I take. I've had my niece and nephew. Last 2 years, I had two nephews. This year, I have my niece from Hawaii. My brother's. Lives in Hawaii.
He does?
Yep.
Where?
He lives on the Big Island. He's the athletic director at Hawaii Prep Academy. Went to Governor's Academy. By then it was Governor Dummer. And he took a 1-year teaching position at HPA. Never came back.
Do they stay with you?
Yep.
Do you charge him for room rent?
No, but I get to stay with them when Stacy and I go out there. Dick,
end of
the first quarter.
Period, 6-1. We'll take a short break and be back with second period action.
Okay.
Big first period for Nantucket. They send out Starr to take the face off. They're backing off a little here?
Maybe resting them up a little bit. It's a demanding position in that. Look at Old Rochester. They're just going right back on defense and not even contesting the ground balls. And that's a defeatist attitude. You got to suck it up and at least try to get some ground balls. Coming off the field for the Whalers, number 15. Bartlett, and onto the field, small, number 6. You got to compete for ground balls. You just can't give it up.
Yeah, for the little that I know about this game, ground balls is more than half the offense, boy.
Campbell and Gambroni have a little two-game, not a good pass. I would say one of the weaknesses in Campbell's game is he does force it a little too often, and he'll learn in time. He's only, obviously an underclassman, but give him some time and he won't force it quite as much. But you'll take, 30, 40 goals for an occasional force, so certainly a good effort throughout the year, but I would just have him be a little more patient if he could. A little bit of a fast break opportunity. Whalers getting back on D.
Well, if number two's got 52 goals, I don't know why he's passing him. I mean, he's in that position.
So you'll see the Whalers sitting back in the zone again. They're content. They'll keep special attention on number two. See that? Just sticks in the passing lane.
But he had the opening near to take the shot. Why does he make the pass?
That'll be a push on white. Should be red ball. Correctly called. Red ball up top.
This game is being played Sunday afternoon at the Vito Capizzo Stadium. Remember, you can watch it online anytime at genotv.com.
See the Whalers, they got to get their sticks up, keep the sticks in their passing lane. Sort of like basketball, keeping your hands up in the passing lane. Same idea. Again, Gogan can sit back there all day long. He might get one or two goals, but they're just not going to come back against the Whalers with this type of offense. And I blame a little bit of this on the coaching staff. This could be an over and back right here. Not a bad idea to kick it forward, but got to contest for the ground balls. Off of White, red, good call.
Yeah, Small had it, trying to pick it up, knocked away from it. Unfortunately, he was the last one to touch it. Rochester's not making very good passes, though.
Young, you know, they're feeling the pressure. You know, if you were to ask half the team right now, they know they're going to lose a game.
Oh, Campbell walks right in. I think he nonchalanted that a little too much.
He just couldn't quite get it ball into his left hand. He switched from right to left.
We forget that he's only a freshman,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, yep.
He's got a lot to learn about this game.
Yeah. Yeah, we talked a little bit about perhaps just being a little more patient, but again, you're scoring 30, 40 goals a year, you can
Sylvia,
unassisted, too fast, too quick, too good, and too many goals for the Whalers. Now 7-1, I believe.
Yes.
9:26 to go, Dick, and how about a fine sponsor or two?
That goal brought to us by the fairgrounds. There's nothing better than a beverage and wings and baseball at the fairgrounds. 15 HTVs, catch your favorite team. And I hope your favorite team is the Boston Red Sox, sitting in first place, although they went down today. 1-0, leadoff batter for Toronto, hit a home run.
Bombed it.
That was it, 1-0?
Joey Batts. No, yeah. They're still playing.
Oh, the game was just starting. Oh, okay. He was the first batter of the game, yeah.
Sylvie in the faceoff again. Good effort here by Old Rochester. Sort of no advantage either way. Now, you can't touch the two people while they're engaged. That's why you don't see the wingmen run over the players. If they're engaged, you cannot check them.
So the ball has to come out before any contact.
Yeah, and usually you'll hear the official yell, balls out, something along those lines. And then you have 10 seconds once you gain possession to get the ball into the box after you cross the midfield line. So you saw Sylvia take the ball, step into the box, and then bring it back out and settle the offense.
Fans are still coming in. I'm looking over there, and some of these fans coming in look like they possibly could be from Old Rochester. You wonder if they came in a later boat or they just decided to have lunch downtown and it was hard to break away to come up to the game.
Well, they probably at one of our fine sponsors like Seagrill.
Seagrill, have a little lunch at the Seagrill before coming over here. And if this game keeps going this way, they'll probably go back to the Seagrill before the end of the game and have a parting cocktail before they get back on the boat.
That one had to hurt. He took that right off the boot. Good save by the goalie. Oh, that was a nice little play by 16 for the Whalers. Lombardi sort of dished it over to Gambroni. Whelan. Red. Ouch.
Wow, that was a quick call.
Marsh Chambers down here just shaking his head.
Yeah, that was a quick call.
Yeah.
Nobody had taken a step yet when he ruled it red.
Ooh, right in the helmet. He missed that one. Got him right in the head. That's okay. We'll let that go. Look at the effort by Gambroni hustling back, clearly out of it.
Oh, nice. A steal! What a steal by Day! Oh!
Good steal, perhaps not a great shot, though. Nice steal. It could have gone a step or two more.
Gus,
nobody backing up either.
Gus should have walked in a few more steps before taking that one.
Really nice effort. Like, there's a good example. That's just a lousy pass right there. Nobody on you. Come on. Successful clear, however. He's in the box. You see the official signifying. So now Old Rochester can operate on offense. There you go, Willett. Whalers content to play zone. Really frustrating when you see a zone. You don't see it that often. That's why I think the Whalers have great success where they can go in and out of their zone and man-to-man.
Ooh, I think that cut the post.
It did hit the post.
Big shot there. And Nantucket dodged one.
The other reason you don't see the zone very much is you really only can play it when you're ahead. Number 4, Terrell, who's one of their big guns.
The post is the goalie's best friend, and it's worked for both teams already today.
And it doesn't count as a shot on net either. Aloisi yelling instructions to its defensive crowd out there. Nice job reacting to that by Bartlett, number 15 for the Whalers. See Nantucket contesting for ground balls and really Old Rochester not.
There's a
hell
save.
Of a save. Now there's a name you don't hear getting enough recognition because you're seeing a lot of this high-octane offense, and that is the effort by Gambroni and Nett the whole year. freshman has had a fabulous season. And he's taken some vicious shots.
You're right, because a lot of the games have been run-up type scores, and you forget about the goalie in those types of games.
If you, I tell you, I'm sure his mom just closes her eyes, but if when he takes his shirt off, his chest protector, and you take a look at his arms and upper body with the welts on him and his legs, it's not a pretty sight. He's had a hell of a year this year, quietly, effectively, and
what a steal!
Deserves a lot of credit.
Robbie Hickman with the steal. Took the ball right off the defender's
Too much stick. One-handed stuff. Need two hands on these ground balls. Gambroni with two hands.
JT,
a headshot, no call.
To walk in, no call. JT gets called for playing without a stick. Now in ice hockey, you can play without a stick. You can't play with a broken stick. You can play without the stick.
Again, another example, just nerves, freshmanitis, you know, throwing the ball away, wasn't pressured at all. Now let's see how Nantucket reacts here. Much more pace and going backwards.
Cole Campbell over in the bench with his head down. He's had injuries on and off this year. Looks like he's dinged up a little over there
now
right
now.
Now
you get 20 seconds to get it over the midfield line. Whalers still have plenty of time. Nope, not a good clear. Not a good clear.
He's off island playing Martha's Vineyard today.
At the Vineyard?
On the Cape.
On the
Vineyard's
Cape?
On the road, aren't they?
Yeah. Playing lacrosse.
Lacrosse on the road? That's the, what, the juniors team?
Yeah, well, 11.
U11, okay. Getting their first taste of the island matchup, huh? Nantucket versus
Coach
Vineyard.
Says these guys are, all the kids he's coached, are the toughest team. We have the best team at that age. That'll be interesting.
See how that plays out.
Shot wide. 7-1 Whalers. 4:34 left in the second quarter, Dick.
He also said something about the guys that are in middle school. They're undefeated. They haven't lost a game.
Which group is this? You mean the U15 and the select?
Yeah, that's it. U15.
Yeah. They got some defensive players in that middle school. They are phenomenal.
So we can really look forward to a few good years.
Yeah, the key to the Whalers is not losing kids to prep school. You know, there's rumors of two or three kids from this team.
Oh.
And, you know, that really, just think of where this team would be if Towns was still here, or one or other, two others.
Nantucket feels the effect of when one or two kids leave because we are
huge.
So small.
I mean, you'd have some of these players who are starters that would be coming off the bench. And I'm just as guilty with my younger starter graduating last
But
last
Quintown,
week from
you
Tabor.
Mentioned for lacrosse, also for football.
That's only a second save of the afternoon because most of the shots have been going in. That's an unsuccessful clear or a successful ride by Nantucket. So they do keep that stat. How many times does the other team not get the ball over midfield, which is a successful ride using the lacrosse term? A bad pass, got lucky there. Gambroni looking to deal. He takes a pounding. I can tell you, being right down on the field, close to the action, he takes a pounding during the game. Nice save in there by the goalie. It's his third save of the afternoon. Mr. Kane, freshman.
Well, Rochester has stepped up their defensive pressure.
They have. Look at this.
Yeah, that's a nice goal. Four with the goal, number two on the assist. That was a nice, you got a turnover and it immediately turned it to offense. That goal brought to us by?
We mentioned the Sea Grill. All the locals go for great fish and excellent seafood. The Sea Grill, 45 Sparks Ave. For reservations or takeout, give them a call, 325-5700. Yeah, that was a good move there. Rochester now showing that they are a pretty good team.
Well, those are two big studs, number two and number four, I believe it was. Two with the assist. Gogan, he's the one that's got over 50 goals. And number four, captain, the second, first goal of the game, 7-2. And again, I apologize to Rochester if I'm butchering their names. Kane I can handle, but I think it's either Terrell or Tyrrell. Flag is down.
There's a penalty on old Rochester.
So once you get it in the box, you have to keep it in the box if there's a penalty. So now they're in. They can't go out. That swim move by number four, Sylvia, walking in alone, shot just over the net.
Okay, we have a power play coming up, and as
first
usual,
penalty of the game.
The first power play of the game, and the power play is brought to us by Outdoor Power Nantucket, 85 Pleasant Street, Nantucket's location for new equipment, parts, and service. Get your lawnmowers and weed whackers tuned up, ready to go. Outdoor Power.
And we'll be doing a new ad for them, a long one tomorrow.
Outdoor Power is getting their ad updated. Look for it here, and we have a timeout on the field with 2:29 to go. Nantucket really controlled the first period. Well, Rochester has brought him back to life this period. I don't know if Nantucket took a little bit of the foot off the pedal, maybe too early to do that.
I was going to mention one of the things I noticed about the zone. When I was doing the Vineyard game, Nantucket was comfortably ahead. I think it was not comfortably, but it was like 3-0, 3-1, 4-1, and they had played a zone up until that point. Immediately upon Sam changing to a man-to-man, the Vineyard scored. They used some pick plays, and within seconds of the Vineyard scoring, Sam immediately went back to the zone. So a good job by Sam to change up his defenses, a better job by the Vineyard recognizing and scoring, but an even better job by Sam realizing that perhaps it wasn't the smartest coaching move, immediately went back to his strength of the zone defense. And if you remember the game, the Vineyard really did mount a tremendous amount of offense. A lot of shots from outside, but Sam's coaching, I thought he really outcoached the Vineyard to that
victory.
Yeah,
he kept Vineyard outside taking the shots, and as you said, he took a lot of shots. A lot of them weren't even on net. Well, Rochester today hasn't taken a lot of the outside shots. They're approaching the zone a little differently, having the number two kids sort of hold the ball behind the net, waiting
right.
for something to break.
Yeah, they get it. If that's a good way of doing it. What I was saying before, if they implement a 1-4-1 offense where they have one guy behind the net, one guy way up top, and then four guys across, so they're forcing Nantucket's, you know, putting two offensive players near one defensive one. So a 1-4-1 offense beats a zone, and Rochester has not gone to that yet.
All right, let's see if Nantucket can take advantage of this power play and get a goal back.
The ball moves quicker in the air than running it, so that's typically what happens in a man-up. You move the ball quickly and faster than the defense can react, so that you want to move it around the zone quick, and eventually you get a bit of a mismatch. There it is, good shot. There's a good example right there. Just found a little crease in the zone. Number 36 for Nantucket with the goal right in tight. And number 36 for the Whalers, as we all know.
Ty.
Yep.
Harnischweger.
Harnischweger with the goal. His uncle Chad, a fabulous tile man on the island.
Hey, do you have an assist on that?
The assist came from up top. I didn't see it. It was the midi up top, and I apologize.
Dean or Jamie, did you get an assist on that? We'll give it to Sylvia.
See that crack statistician.
Dean Geddes over there. Jack Sylvia with the assist. So he has two goals and two assists now.
He does. A nice smile by Coach Marsh Chambers to Harnischweger, who scored the goal. I think Coach Chambers might have had a little something to do with that play to score. Sylvia off, Small on, number 15 for the Whalers. Bartlett off, number 16 onto the field for Nantucket. Mr. Lombardi. Good to see them work up a good sweat, like you said, and not hopefully no injuries here. Just sort of, ooh, wow, high.
You got the 6-goal lead again here now, and you're still attacking. You'd like to get another one. I think they saw when they took the attack off there a little bit, their offense ground down a little bit. So I think they probably want to keep this attack going.
Yep.
Get up to double digits, then you can relax again.
Well, you know, if you notice, I don't know if Gino can get it, but they're shadowing Small, number 6, number 52. So basically you're paying a 5-on-5. If Gino can get it about midfield,
yeah,
number
6,
Small
about?
For the Whalers is not even in the offense, but they're shadowing him. I don't know if they got some film on him.
That all about?
Well, they're saying basically you're too good and you're going to beat us. And I would, if you're going to shadow anybody, you're going to shadow Gambroni.
So what are they in? As boxer one sort of?
Well, they're playing, and they're saying that we have a better chance of stopping you 5-on-5 as opposed to 6-on-6.
Well, they didn't stop them. I thought that was in.
And I would shadow Gambroni. Doesn't have his offensive skills too, because he's just so damn fast. But I think that's a coaching error there.
25.
See, because Gambroni is a threat to pass and shoot at the highest level. Where Small is a better dodger and shooter. I wouldn't say his passing skills are his strength. Whereas Gambroni.
Gambroni is
a two-headed monster.
Right.
Nice score in there, a nice save in there. Gambroni with a nice save just before the buzzer. All right, Coach.
So one point and a half here. It's Nantucket 8, Old Rochester 2. We'll take a short break and be back with second half action.